It was a dark and stormy night. But then it turned into a really nice day, and we got to go to the beach again and play with the kids. And for the first time, we were able to actually do our teaching lessons. So we played the Hokey Pokey with them.
And then some of the groups did flashcards involving animals and their English counterparts. Got the kids involved. And then some of the groups played Simon Says. We had to clap and turn. Clap some more. One of us couldn't get it. Hey. And then we played Sharks and Minnows. Who knew these kids were so fast? Lastly, we played Duck Duck Goose, or the Portuguese game of Pato e Gato. And then we broke for lunch.
So we're going on a run to a bunch of different hardware stores to get equipment and construction tools that we need for when we go to Chinese art exhibition in the area. First place we are, we have a spray painter who's going to help us paint the iron gates that we're going to have.
So after braving the San Fernando traffic, we are now here this construction worker's house. And he is building the door that's going to replace the one we're tearing down on Jamie and Georgette's house. And we're giving him a down payment today and also dropping off some supplies later so that he can make the door and have it ready for us.
We are here and they treat us to this fruit called
pitomba.
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 And it's the most delicious thing I've ever tasted.
Moly moly.
Let's
try
it.
Step one.
Crack open.
Step two.
Step three.
Enjoy.
We're at Jaime and Georgette's again. This is our third stop for the day, just to pick up some stuff. But when we got here, the wood people came. And this wood is, we're not sure what it's going to be used for, but it's here. So that's my story, and I'm sticking to it. I can't describe how it smells, but it's just, it's so like freshly cut and solid and woody, I guess you could say.
This is stop number four on our trip of construction stuff. We are at a place where they're building iron grates that are eventually going to go somewhere in the house. I don't really know what they're going to do, but they're going to be there, so we're stopping them now to find out some more information, maybe make a payment, hopefully not take it home because we don't have capability to do that on our bikes.
Thanks for following us on our day around San Fernando.
We still haven't seen Scott yet, but we're hoping he'll be back tomorrow. So stay tuned for more from Team Cole.